a welcome friend and stranger at the table of the Savior. All are welcome, all are welcome here. From the woman who comes crying, leaving tears at Jesus' feet, to the man who knows the right way but cannot see. All are welcome, friend and stranger, at the banquet of the Savior. All are welcome here. From the ones who feel forgotten, those who sense their place is gone, to the ones who live in hunger, here you belong. All are welcome, friend and stranger, at the banquet of the Savior. All are welcome here. Go into the streets and cities, to the farms and families, about the splendid table, God's mercy. All are welcome, a friend and stranger, at the banquet of the Savior. All are welcome here.
Thank you. And good evening and welcome to Wednesday night worship with United Lutheran Church. Sometimes the weeks can be long, but on Wednesday nights we come together for a time of worship. We breathe deep the breath of God and are renewed by God's life-giving word for our lives. Tonight, our scripture reading is from 1 Corinthians, the 8th chapter. Throughout these weeks after the Epiphany, we've been talking about how God shows up in Jesus. And tonight's reading helps us to explore how God shows up in Jesus to set us free for lives of love and service for our neighbor. There's some announcements to be made, and you can find them in the worship bulletin. The first one that I want to call your attention to is a series of events that have been created by United's evangelism team. We're calling it Community Connection. And these are monthly offerings that are designed to offer help, inspiration, and encouragement during these often challenging days. The next Community Connection will be taking place next week on Thursday, February 11th from 7 to 8 p.m. You can join it either by Zoom or on Facebook Live. If you're looking for a Zoom link, you can find it in our weekly emails from United, or if you're having trouble getting connected, call the church office and we'll do all that we can to help you get connected. This month, February, our speaker is Jennifer Modine. She is a licensed master of social work, and Jennifer is going to be focusing on what the pandemic can teach us about ourselves and our community and about self-care. Also, during these cold winter months, United has been about serving our community, and this month we're focusing on feeding our neighbors. The Love Feast is taking place with United as the host on Tuesday, February 23rd, and that will be taking place at Zion United Methodist. We'll be using all of the good practices that we know to feed our neighbors, and be watching for opportunities on how you can be connected and help serve. Also, Meals for LaGrave on First are ongoing during the month of February, and if you'd like to be a part of feeding our neighbors through that ministry, simply contact the church office or go online through our Facebook, through our church website. United will be resuming in-person worship for Lent of 2021, and that will begin on Ash Wednesday, which is February 17th, with services at both noon and 7 p.m. that day. Thank you, as we gather for worship, to our worship team, our musicians, and to our technicians, and we are thankful to be with you all for this time of worship. And I'll invite our worship team to lead us in our opening song.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Longing for food, many are hungry. Longing for water, many still thirst. Make us your bread, broken for others, shared until all are fed. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Longing for shelter, many are homeless. Longing for warmth, many are cold. Make us your building, sheltering others. Walls made of living stone. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts. Shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gather today. Many the gifts, many the people, many the hearts that yearn to belong. Let us be servants to one another, sight of your kingdom come. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you.
The brightness of God's light shines upon all the nations. All are welcomed to the brightness of God's dawn.
God gathers us from far away and carries us. With radiant eyes, with rejoicing hearts, we receive the abundance God gives.
We respond in praise. With our gifts, with our very selves, we worship God.
Let your light scatter the darkness.
And shine within your people here.
And let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. With your abundant grace and might, free us from the sin that would obstruct your mercy. That willingly we may bear your redeeming love to all the world. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Christ be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church gathered today.
Our scripture reading for this evening comes from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, the 8th chapter. Paul writes, "Now concerning food sacrificed to idols, we know that all of us possess knowledge. Knowledge puffs up, but love builds up. Anyone who claims to know something does not yet have the necessary knowledge, but anyone who loves God is known by him. Hence, as to the eating of food offered to idols, we know that no idol in the world really exists, and that there is no God but one. Indeed, even though there may be so-called gods in heaven and on earth, as in fact there are many gods and many lords, yet for us there is one God, the Father, from whom all things and for whom we exist, and one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom all things and through whom we exist. It is not everyone, however, who has this knowledge, since some have become so accustomed to idols until now, they still think of the food they eat as food offered to an idol, and their conscience, being weak, is defiled. Food will not bring us close to God. We are not worse off if we do not eat, and no better off if we do. But take care that this liberty of yours does not somehow become a stumbling block to the weak. For if others see you who possess knowledge eating in the temple of an idol, might not they, since their conscience is weak, be encouraged to the point of eating food sacrificed to idols? So by your knowledge, those weak believers for whom Christ died are destroyed. But when you thus sin against members of your family and wound their conscience when it is weak, you sin against Christ. Therefore, if food is the cause of their falling, I will never eat meat, so that I may not become a cause of one of them to fall." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
And now we present our Not Ready for Any Time Players, proudly presents I Got Rights. We meet Michael, an all-American, dashingly handsome male, a man who knows his rights, but sadly isn't very thoughtful.
Wow, would you look at all those sheeple?
I'm sorry, Michael. What do you mean, sheeple?
You know, people who act like sheep.
Sorry, I'm still not tracking with you.
Look at them. They're all just going to go along with the mandates like sheep.
Oh, you mean they're all wearing masks. Isn't that a good thing?
Yeah, it is if you want to be a sheep. But not me. I will not be bound by that kind of stuff. I know better. I am no sheep. I'm a goat.
A goat? What do you mean by goat?
Got our open freedom.
Michael, that does not spell goat. That spells goof.
Molly, never try to confuse me with the facts, okay? I just got to be free, Molly. I got rights, you know. Can't let anyone infringe on my freedom. Oh, by the way, I wanted to invite you to a little gathering I'm having on Saturday night.
You're having a little gathering? How many is little?
60, 70 people, maybe more.
60 or 70 people?
Yeah.
Michael, don't you think that's pretty risky?
Risky? Why?
Michael, I've seen your place. It's not that big. Your little gathering would be packed. Aren't you worried that some of your guests will get the virus?
Oh, you think so? Guess I hadn't thought of that. Well, would that be bad?
Bad? Of course, that would be so bad. We are supposed to care for others. We're supposed to make sure our actions don't cause other people harm.
Yes, but what about my rights? I'm a free citizen with rights.
Yes, of course you have rights. But what about others? What about if you are exercising your rights and your freedoms cause harm to someone else? Mm. Just because we can do some things doesn't mean we should do something.
Yeah, I suppose you've got a point there.
Jesus calls us to love one another. We can't really love our neighbors if by our actions we're causing them harm, can we?
No, Molly, no, you're absolutely right. I'm going to call the whole party off right now.
And?
And I'm going to start wearing my mask from now on, but I'm not going to like it.
Well, nobody likes it, Michael, but you're doing the right thing.
That's right. Molly taught Michael an important lesson tonight. Sometimes you have to give up a few freedoms to show love and care for your neighbor. Come back next time and see how Michael learns the joys of composting. Bye-bye for now. Well, our little drama wasn't necessarily meant to be picking on anyone, but it does remind us that our freedoms can be a source of harm to others. You know, the Apostle Paul had a similar problem in a church that he was writing to in Corinth. There he was dealing with people who thought they knew better than others about what it meant to be a good Christian. They thought their knowledge gave them certain rights and freedoms to do things that, well, that might cause other Christians to question their faith. The issue was food sacrificed to idols. Now, granted, that's not a big problem with churches today. I'll grant you that. But these Christians thought that they knew that because there was no such thing as other gods, but there was only one true God, therefore idols and temples to these non-existent gods, well, that meant nothing to them. It was therefore perfectly okay for them to eat food that was sacrificed to these idols at local festivals. Now, I want you to imagine in your heads a giant barbecue where they hand out free food to everyone. Well, that's what these festivals would be like. And the menu was usually this grilled meat, and sometimes people didn't get grilled meat or any kind of meat very often. Well, the problem was that other Christians, maybe they were newer to the faith, well, they struggled with the idea about eating food at these festivals because they thought to themselves, doesn't this mean we're worshiping these other gods? They had grown used to this. They'd grown up with this. How could they just kind of shift gears so quickly and now learn that, oh, there aren't any other gods, so it's okay to eat the food? Well, by doing this, they might be led astray and stop worshiping and believing the one and only God through Jesus Christ. Well, the Apostle Paul said it is better to be a vegetarian than to harm the faith of another. And he told them not to let their freedom get in the way of the needs of others. As Molly shared in our little skit, if we are to love our neighbor, if we are to love others, we must think of their needs first before our own, before even our own freedom and our rights. We're called to be people who love our neighbor, and that might call upon us to give up some things from time to time, but that's okay because we are caring for those other brothers and sisters in need. Amen.
Glorified, be glorified.
of our walk of faith as believers is that we offer a portion of what God has first given us for God's work in the world. We continue to give thanks for all of you who offer a portion of what God has given you to do God's work through the ministries and mission of this congregation. You may continue to share your offerings either by making a secure online donation or by mailing your offerings to United Lutheran Church. Let us pray. God, our salvation, receive the gifts we offer and bless them for the work of your kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We lift our voices, we lift our hands, we lift our lives up to you, we are an offering. Lord, use our voices, Lord, use our hands, Lord, use our lives, they are yours, we are an offering.
Light of God's love and grace poured out in Jesus Christ, let us pray for the church, for the world, and for all who are in need. God of light, give your justice to the nations and their leaders, and give your mercy to all whose decisions affect the peace and well-being of the world. Where we have power ourselves, open our ears to the cries of the weak, the poor, and the needy, and open our hearts to answer their call. Bless this month our feeding of those who are hungry through the Love Feast and through meals prepared for La Grave on First. Lord, in your mercy,
be our light.
God of light, bless this community, that in your light we might each become a servant, one to the other. Bring us together in story, song, joy, and sorrow, and let every child who comes among us find welcome. Guide us as we prepare to return again to in-person worship. Lord, in your mercy,
be our light.
God of light, have mercy on those among us who journey in sickness, fear, or any kind of trouble. Meet them on their road with rest, peace, and healing. Lord, in your mercy,
be our light.
God of light, we pray this evening for the grace to receive your gifts, to lift our eyes and look around, and to offer back those same gifts to you and to your world with love. Lord, in your mercy,
be our light.
We pray these things in the name of the one who is our companion on the way and our journey's end, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Amen. Gathered as one in Jesus' name, let us pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. and receive the blessing. The God of glory dwell in you richly, name you beloved, and shine brightly on your path. And the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace, be the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
I'm so glad.